Welcome to this video on parsing in compiler design. In this session, we will provide an overview of various parsing techniques and algorithms. This video will introduce key techniques and terminologies without describing their details. Do not worry, our series includes dedicated videos that thoroughly explain each technique for a deeper understanding. Parsing is the process of checking whether a program's code conforms to the syntax rules of the programming language. A parser takes as input a stream of tokens generated by a lexical analyzer along with a context-free grammar. Its output can be either a parse tree or a syntax tree, depending on the level of abstraction required. The parse tree includes both terminals and non-terminals from the context-free grammar, while the syntax tree omits non-terminal and emphasizes the logical structure of the expression. In the following diagram, both parse tree and a syntax tree are shown for the input 9 times 7 plus 1. What happens if parsing fails? In such cases, the parser does not produce a tree. Instead, it generates a list of syntax errors such as missing semicolons, unbalanced parentheses, or mismatched keywords. Now that we understand the purpose of parsing, let's visualize the hierarchy of parsing algorithms using a tree. I will build and explain this tree step by step. Parsing techniques can be divided into two main branches: top-down parsing and bottom-up parsing. In top-down parsing, we start from the start symbol of the context-free grammar and derive towards the input. In contrast, bottom-up parsing starts with the input and reduces it back to the grammar's start symbol. Under top-down parsing, there are two primary techniques. The first technique is LL1 parsing, which scans the input from left to right and constructs a leftmost derivation of the parse tree. This technique usually uses a single look-ahead symbol. The second technique is recursive descent parsing, a widely used approach for implementing top-down parsing. Recursive descent parsing itself can be categorized into three variations. The first variation is the typical or vanilla recursive descent parsing, which directly implements the grammar as recursive function. The second variation is recursive descent parsing with first and follow sets, which uses these sets to improve efficiency and resolve ambiguities. The third variation is recursive descent parsing with backtracking, where the parser attempts alternative grammar rules when a parsing decision fails. While backtracking can be computationally expensive, it is especially useful for handling ambiguous grammars. One limitation of top-down parsing is its inability to handle left recursive grammars, since many context-free grammars are inherently left recursive, bottom-up parsing is often preferred for practical use. Now, let's discuss bottom-up parsing. Bottom-up parsing relies on LR parsing algorithms, where the L indicates that the input is scanned from left to right. The R refers to the use of rightmost derivations in reverse. These algorithms are based on two types of finite automatons. The first is the LR0 automaton, which represents the simplest form of bottom-up parsing and uses a deterministic finite automaton to construct the parse tree. The second is LR1 automaton, which is more advanced version that incorporate a single look-ahead token to guide parsing decisions. From these automatons, we derive three key parsing schemes. Number one is SLR, or simple LR parsing. This uses LR0 automaton with look ahead for simple grammar rules. Second scheme is canonical LR parsing, a more comprehensive method that uses LR1 automaton to handle complex grammars. Finally, we have look-ahead LR parsing, a refined version of CLR that combines states with identical cores, making it more memory efficient. Among all these parsing schemes, CLR is most powerful, as it can handle the largest set of context-free grammars. However, these powers come at the cost of increased complexity and slower parsing speed. As a result, many programming languages adopt LALR parsing, or which is less powerful than CLR, but sufficient for most programming languages' syntax, making them a practical choice. In the upcoming videos, we will discuss these parsing schemes in greater details. Links to those videos are provided in the description if you like to explore them right away. Thank you for watching and supporting this channel. If you enjoyed this video and would like to help me continue creating valuable content, check out the links to support me in the description. See you later. Bye.